And welcome back to American Agenda. I'm Heather Childers, along with Bob Sellers. Black Lives Matter co-founder Patrice Cullors now releasing a statement addressing the controversy around her mystery millions that she is spending on luxury homes. In the statement, she blames racism and white terrorism over the allegations. Well, Black Lives Matter issued this statement as well, saying the right-wing offensive not only puts Patrice, her child, and her loved ones in harm's way, it also continues a tradition of terror by white supremacists against Black activists. So how can a self-avowed Marxist with have such a large portfolio of luxury homes? Where did all those millions come from? And we should say that Black Lives Matter did say that they have not paid her anything since 2019, but she was paid a total of, I think, $120,000 from Black Lives Matter for their work or her work with them between 2013 to 2019. So, Jesse Jane, I'll start with you. I mean, a socialist and a Marxist, but she has millions of dollars in property.
Well, on Twitter, people have posted BLM now stands for Buy Luxury Mansions. Essentially, when we talk about what she's been paid, I doubt that those numbers are accurate because it has been disclosed that she's part of several different entities. You have nonprofits, non-for-profits, and you also have corporations. In fact, the money is very difficult. It's a nebulous web that is very difficult to trace where this money is going. I find it very hard to be empathetic to her because I agree with her on one thing. There is a double standard. We don't see the FBI putting up the photos of the BLM protesters as we have with the January 6th people that went into the Capitol. With that, we have not heard much about any accountability of those that were shot and killed during BLM riots that went on. A security officer was wanted off the top of my head. In fact, I believe there were two. In fact, we've had billions of dollars in damages done by these riots and little to no recourse for the people that were victimized by this, often being the very Black citizens of those cities. So yes, she's right. There is a double standard, but it isn't white extremism. It's essentially that the media and apparently the Department of Justice and or FBI turns it away in exploiting it as they have with the January 6th events at the Capitol.
Yeah, I mean, Derek, she says that anyone questioning her property and her wealth, that it's a tactic of terror to discredit and silence her. But along with the high dollar number, this neighborhood that she's going to be living in Los Angeles, it's 88% white and only 1.8% Black. And she was the founder of Black Lives Matter.
Okay, I had to laugh off of that one because here's the thing. This organization, obviously, Black Lives Matter. Okay, let me say that.
Right.
However, I think the organization and for what the mission it stands for is the most hypocritical organization that's out there. Because last week when you guys had me on the show, I was just looking at, because Black Lives Matter, they only show up when the lights are on, when there's a police shooting and they need, and the spotlight's on them. And as I told my son, Derek, who had a track meet yesterday, it's what you do when the lights are off. What work are you doing behind the scenes? And so we're last night in Washington, D.C., we had three people murdered. The night before that, there were two people murdered. And you can go on days and days and days where people are murdered in these major cities across the country. Where's Black Lives Matter then? And so that's the problem I have with them. And who knows where she's getting this funding, because we know it's coming from Soros and these other organizations. But she's such a hypocrite. The whole organization is a hypocrite.
Yeah. Steve, what do you think? You're shaking your head, agreeing.
Right. No, listen, this is the height of hypocrisy. Mm-hmm. Derek's exactly correct. it's reprehensible that she has bought, by the way, four homes in recent years for a total of $3.2 million, including the one you mentioned, Heather, outside of Los Angeles in an almost exclusively white area. Mm-hmm. By the way, in one of the most diverse areas of America, the greater Los Angeles area. It's not like it's hard to find diversity there if she wanted to live among people of color. She has clearly chosen otherwise, buying a $1.4 million mansion there. And again, the idea that she hasn't been paid directly by BLM does not mean that indirectly she hasn't been massively paid by BLM or similar organizations. Look, being a Marxist, I have to say this, it makes you chuckle a bit. Being a Marxist apparently pays pretty well these days. Karl Marx would have been shocked.
What a country. What a country.
And she signed a major deal with Warner Brothers as well, Bob.
I didn't even know that. Mm-hmm. But to me, What strikes me about her is she plays the race card in every single issue, right? Plays the race card in what's going on in a police incident. Plays the race card here when people are just saying, wait a minute, where'd you get all that money? Because tens of millions have been raised on behalf of what you represent, Black Lives Matter. So you're playing that. So all people want to know is, okay, where's that money coming from? Because the average person is not going out and buying multiple homes for millions of dollars. They can't. So if you're like them, if you feel their pain and you want to change the system, why not just be open? Why not be transparent? No, she says it's white terrorism to question her.
Yeah.
That just seems completely inappropriate. If she really wants to play this game, if she wants to be somebody that matters, tell us where the money came from. Tell us how it got into those homes, why you invested into those. I believe in capitalism. I have no problem with people buying homes and multiple homes. But when you claim that challenging it or questioning it makes you a white terrorist, really?
Yeah, and that's the problem that I have with it. I mean, it's not that she doesn't have a right to make money and to further herself and have this property, but the hypocrisy behind it, I think a lot of people are questioning, including all of those who raise money for Black Lives Matter.
And, you know, Heather and Bob, I think this is important, too. Bob, you brought up the point that she is infusing race into a discussion where it has no relevance.
Right.
That is what these professional agitators do all the time, right? And they are trying to create, it's really kind of fascinating, I think, in a sense. We live in a country right now that has largely defeated racism in any systemic way, right? There are no racist laws on the books anymore. It is not culturally acceptable anywhere in America to be racist. And this is a battle that has largely been won, particularly among young people. When you talk to young people, for example, my children who are teens, they don't even see, literally don't even see race in people. And yet, agitators like Patrice Cullors are insistent on inflicting and infusing a discussion of racism where there's no actual evidence of racism. Why? Because it garners them tremendous power and, in her case, tremendous wealth.
Yeah, it looks like it. All right, we're going to take a break.